Hello YouTube, this is my official Punisher Warzone figure that I made myself. Actually, the vest is pretty much the only thing I really made. Like, I had sewed the pockets on here. This, I think I got it just about right. The skull, I used whiteout to paint the skull on it, whatever. I don't know what most people use for. Then I sewed all these things. I don't know if you can see, like, I got the clip pouch there. And I have these little things, you know, the stuff that, you know, people use to put the pockets on. I sewed those on individually. Vest is a little shorter, but it was the only one I thought that looked like the old, the you know, the one in the movie. Kind of had it had this thing. And I sewed these shoulders on. I think I got the neck part right, just about right. And I got the holster right here. And I have pretty much every weapon he has. I got this thing. I got two of those. There we are. And this I didn't really work too much on. I was just kind of having fun with the revolver. In the last movie, it kind of sucks. I wasn't really working hard on it. But this one, I painted them silver, which... it was a bad idea because they ended up getting stuck. I can't, like, you can usually pull the slide back. You can't do it anymore or it'll get stuck. But other than that, I got the holster, both holsters. You can put something in there. Right there. See it? I've also got his knife. Where's the knife? There it is. See? I actually made a custom knife, but didn't work out so well. It broke in half, so I just kind of just painted this silver, painted it like it up like his knife. See, kind of silver, you know, it's got like that little butcher knife handle kind of thing. Painted it silver, and it fits neatly in his. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. What else? Got the sweater. Sweater looks all right. I kind of sewed the things like right here just to make it look a little like, because when I got the sweater it looked kind of big for him, and in the movie it looks a little tight on him. I aimed to perfection. And see, I got the clip things from the house, and you can put the clips in there. Oh, you have to put two in or else it won't stay, but you get the idea. I can't really put the second one in. And I got pretty much everything from the opening, from these things. Handle with care. Medium, strike face, whatever the hell that means, I don't know. Then I got this. They used to assassinate the guy that was jumping from the roof. That seems pretty funny. I remember he was using this. He didn't use it. He was like cleaning it, and I'm assuming it was like a reference to all the old movies, because Frank Caslte prefers the M1911, and I got this revolver just for fun because it kind of reminds me of the one, but I don't have the S&W 500's revolver. I know Hot Toys is probably making one. They have one for that, those new Resident Evil 5 figures coming out. And I pretty much just got whatever he had in the movie. Like, I only saw one flash grenade and one grenade. That's all I saw. So, and this one, I like this flash grenade. It has like a little description on it. I don't know if you can see it. But this is actually the only M4 I can come up with. Unfortunately, I don't know. I know it sucks, but it looks like it, and yeah, that's good enough for me. It has the, it looks kind of like the grenade launcher and the sight and the silencer. I don't know. I mean, I don't know where to get the grenade launcher yet. I mean, I do have like another M203 one, like from the first movie with Thomas Jane, but I was kind of thinking of putting that together, kind of like a reference to both movies. Because I was going to kitbash the Thomas Jane figure. I have everything, I just like, I don't really have like a figure to put it on. He's the only one I have right now. So, and the other clip. I think that's everything. Oh, I forgot, of course. Two submachine guns from, I don't know if you can see the handle, I still have a little handle on here, but I got the two submachine guns. I don't want to take them out right now. I can't really take them out. But yeah, you can see them. I didn't paint them silver. I know they're silver in the movie. Believe me. I would not miss a detail like that. So, don't think that I haven't overseen every single little detail. You know, I got the shoulders, and I've seen Punisher Warzone like thousands of times because he's like the best superhero ever. Then there's his watch. I noticed in the watch he has a regular watch with a black handle and a silver area right there. So I think I got that right. And actually, this handgun, it doesn't fit in the holster, but I noticed he uses a weapon that looks like this, which is kind of weird. I think it's like a sidearm kind of thing because he already had like enough guns on him to. But he, I don't know. It looks like it, but I'm pretty sure he used a shorter version. I'm not sure what it's called. I think it's called a USP or something. 45, whatever. I'm not a gun expert, but I just go by because I found this great website that like shows all the guns ever used in every movie. That's how I found out about this one. But it just looks like it, but it's not supposed to be that big, you know. And I think I get the face part about right. I know he has like a. I looked at his hair. He doesn't have the widow's peak, but whatever. It looks like him. He's got the hair combed back, and if you can see, I kind of painted his face a little bit. You can see the. It actually looks better this way, because actually I just used the same silver paint I used on the handle, on the knife and the guns, but then I used like some pen marks to kind of give him that bearded look, like I haven't shaved, I haven't shaved in like forever, not since my family was killed. Anyway, I don't know if you, just one more last look, because I was really happy when the vest came out. I was so afraid to sew it together. And it wasn't easy, I'll tell you that much. A lot of holes in my fingers, just stabbing myself. Still hurts. This is the holster. I'll show you what it looks like with the... Hold on a second. There we go. This is just the beginning. I love that scene. You know, funny thing is, I thought he'd say that in the beginning of the movie. It would make more sense because the movie's over after he just killed him. Sorry, I didn't mean to spoil it. And that's what he looks like with all the guns. I love this version better because I love the beginning of the scene where he just like slices off that mob boss's head and it's still hanging on there. You have to really look at it. You can totally tell it's not like it's still hanging on there. And then he like stabs some guy's arm with his own broken bone. Ugh, I don't know if anyone noticed that. That was kind of funny. I think I got this part about right. It probably should be a little lower, because he's got a weird neck, I noticed, because it's like one minute he's like this, like you can tell he's like this, and then the next minute he's kind of like, his head's like sticking out. I mean, his neck is like 2 inches taller than before. I don't know. I can't figure it out. I think that's it. Oh, and I got the shoes. Oh, knife thing going. Pretty much, the only thing I know I'm missing is, like, I noticed, I don't know if anyone can help me out with this, but I noticed he had, like, two pockets here. I think that's where he kept the grenades, but it looks kind of weird. I couldn't figure it out. Like, he had some kind of pouch there at the end of the movie when he had the grenades, and I know he had something right here, like, somewhere around here. I think where he puts the grenades, and you can't really see it because it's all dark in the movie, but I know that's what he used to put the grenades in. I don't really have that since I don't have the grenade launcher. I didn't bother with it. Plus, like, the vest is actually kind of small, so I couldn't really, like, put the... if I put it right here, it'll kind of ruin it, because I want everyone to notice the... I don't know if you guys can see it. I put in all this little detail, the individual things, like, on a real vest. And I said it before, I used white out. And it just... This is the only white paint I had that I know would stay on for a long time until it, like, chips off, and we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. If the skull doesn't look right, let me know, because I'm pretty sure, like, it looks about right. I did this thing over 1,000 times. You can notice, like, the marker around there, I kind of, like, outlined it a little bit to fix it up, to clean it up a little bit. And, oh yeah, I forgot about the gloves. Definitely, I got the gloves. I bought some gloves off this great website. And I just cut the fingers off, and I was a little afraid to do it, because I always hate ruining my own stuff, you know what I mean? I remember as a kid, I always used to do that, and then I'd end up regretting it. But, actually, this came out nicely. The only thing I don't have is that crossbow thing he had, the little square thing, that was pretty cool. another microchip specialist. I think I got this part about right. This part was the trickiest part.